Hello everyone, to all the Form 5 students. Today we will start another lesson on variation. So actually for direct variation, you just learned that it's actually not a combination of many variables. So if there is a combination of more variables, okay, three or more variables, that is so-called joint variation. So okay, today we will focus on joint variation. So example, simple interest. Okay, simple interest is I equal to PRT. P is the principal, R is the interest rate, and time is the T. So what is the relation of the variable I with the variable P, R, and T? So now, today our main focus, our learning standard is determine the relation between three or more variables for given joint variation. Okay, so let's have a look of the example here. So before that, we go through the concept. In a joint variation, Y varies jointly X, Xm and Zn can be written as Y varies jointly as Xm and n is multiplied. So multiply, normally we just we don't write, we just write close to each other. So this is called relation of the variation. So because this is the relation, so when we want to do calculation, we have to convert to equation, right? So once you convert to equation, the constant must be there. Okay, the constant must be there. So the constant is actually a number which unchanged. Alright, so today we will discuss joint variation. Okay, one example of the joint variation is the simple interest. Okay, so let's see the example here. So you see when you read the example, the relation, okay, we always use the proportionate to, okay, the symbol. So P varies directly as Q and square root R. So you can write like this, it's joined with the square root R. Okay, then for B, Y, so when we read Y, we will write Y varies as a square of W and cube of the X. Cube is power 3. Alright, so that's how we write the joint variation. Okay, so we join them together. So finally, we have to make it into an equation, right, by putting the k in front. So you can write like this, k w square and then x cube. All right so these are the example, so you can go through for the rest almost the same. For example number 10 also, so you're given this one, so when you write into equation, okay, you have to automatically you have to write the k when you convert the relation into equation. So you can substitute the value given and find the k. After you find the k, you will substitute back the k into here, so you get the equation like this. Alright, so this is actually the express, we call as express x in terms of y and z. Okay, x equal to how many y and how many z. Alright, so this is in terms of y and z. Okay, x in terms of y and z, meaning that the x can have a number, can have the y, can have the z, right? Okay, settle. So these are the question about the Hodge question on the joint radiation. Gravitational potential energy E, okay, E varies. We highlight the keywords varies. So E varies directly as the mass followed by acceleration G and its position height. So we can just multiply together as a joint variation, and then we will convert into first of all you have to write the relation in the form of equation by adding the K, and then you have to substitute all the value given, okay, into the equation, and then you solve the K. So the K, after you obtain the K, you have to substitute the K back to equation, so you get finally the simpler equation. Alright, so if this question is in a table form, you can actually write down like this. So you can actually just write the relationship between them first before you substitute into the equation. Okay, so as the question say, S varies as T, and the cube root, there's a root, so you have to write cube root. Okay, here is 3, and then you have to convert to K, T, and then cube root of U, and you substitute one pair of the values. All these values are given, so that means you can use this this set of STU, okay, substitute to find the K. Right, so after you substitute the STU into there, you will find the K. Once you got the K, okay, K is 2.5, you must actually substitute back into the equation and write a new equation before you can solve for the question asking by the question. Okay, so after that you just plug in whatever information asking by the question and you solve your x. Okay, so that's how you find the answer, and you may also ask for another variable, so you substitute again for the third set of data, then you solve the y. Okay, right, so I'm going to discuss question on 1.1c. So for this one, you have to do in your exercise book. For 1.1c, let's do it now. Okay, you have to write the index number 3, okay, for the joint variation. Okay, this is the third class for variation. All right, so for number one, x, when you see varies, you write the symbol like this directly as t and u, like that, simple. N means multiply, the n here means multiply. Okay, settle. V for the b, v varies directly as w square x. All right, for C, A varies directly cube of B. A varies cube of B, cube, this is cube of B, and the square root, there's a root, square root of C, right? Okay, D. So we are not asking to find the equation, so we just write the symbol, the area of the curve A. So A of the cylinder varies directly as the radius and its height, like this. Alright, so set number one settle. For question number one, you need to do in the exercise book. So all the questions that I discussed, you need to do in the exercise book. Okay, so let's discuss 2A. P varies directly. So we write P varies directly as Q cubed. And N is multiply. So you don't have to write a multiply because we actually knew that when the two numbers are close to each other, it means multiply, right? So, okay, after you write this, you need to convert to equation. So it become P equal to K Q 3 R cubed, right? Now you need to substitute. The P is 5.184. Okay, K is unknown that we need to find. Q is 1.2 power 3. And then R is 216 cube root, right? So you can actually solve the number by taking these two, bring over, divided. Okay, so your K is 5.184 divided by 1.2 power 3 times the 216. And then you have the cube root, right? 1/3, that is. Okay, so you can press a calculator to find the constant K. So what is the K? You solve it, you will get K equal to 0.5, right? Okay, how you press your calculator is you press 5.184, right? Then you divide by 1.2 to the power of 3. You can press equal first. You got 3, and then you divide by cube root. Cube root of the 216 is actually 6, isn't it? So you get 1/2 or 0.5. Alright, so the question asks you to solve the find the constant, right? So just solve the constant. You don't have to write the equation. That means K is 1/2. Got it? Okay, so this one you do on your own. So I will discuss number 3. I will just discuss one question for every question. Then the other one you do on your own. Okay, for this one 3A you do on your own. I do 3B, right? Y varies directly as X and square of Z. Like this. Immediately you convert to equation kxz squared, right? Then you will substitute y equal to 6, and then k is a constant that you need to find, 0.64 and 5 squared. Alright, so what is the constant? It's actually 6/0.64 times 5 squared. So 6/0.64 over 25, right? So your answer is 3. Your K is 3/8, right? For this one, for 3B. Okay, once you got 3/8, you don't stop that because the question say express Y in terms of X and Z. So you're not asking to find just constant. You're asking to find Y equal to substitute here. Okay, substitute here. Your K is 3/8 and then xz squared. This is the answer for B. Alright. Okay, that is so called express Y in terms of xz. That means it can have number and X and Z. Okay, so we have discussed number 3. Now you have to do it on your own for A. Now, I would like to discuss number 4 for joint variation. This is a bit hot because it involves a story, alright? The price, okay, of a metal rod, X, so we write X, varies directly, so varies directly as the length P and the square of radius. So when you read the question, you will write the information, square of radius. If a metal rod with a length of 150 and radius 3 cm. Okay, so now we convert to equation with the constant P R squared. So the length is given 150, meaning that the P is 150 and the radius is 3 square. Alright, and then the price is 27. Alright, you substitute carefully. I'm sure you can solve the K. So let's see your K. This is K times 9 times 150. 27 here. So that means the K will be equal to 27 divide. You bring over, you'll be divide by 9 and divide by 150. Alright, so the answer is 27 divided by 9 divided by 150. So you will get 1 over 50 or 0.02, right? Okay, so now the question is asking write the equation. They want the equation. That means you will substitute here for 1 over 50, right? So that means the equation will be, answer will be x equal to, okay, the answer will be x equal to 1 over 50 p r square, right? Substitute into here. Okay, settle. Now I've discussed number 4. So how about number 5? Okay, let's see number 5. Okay, I will do one of the question, then the rest you do on your own. So this is g varies directly as h, and square root m. Okay, so I'm going to convert to g is equal to kh square root m. So you're given g 42, k you need to find, and h you're given 7, and then square root 16, right? So 42 equal to k times 7 times 4. So that means k is equal to 42 over 28, right? So you press your calculator, so your answer is 1.5 or 3 over 2, right? So you can write again the equation by substitute into here. That means the g is equal to 1.5, and then k, big K, and h, your big K is actually your g equal to 1.5 is a k, h square root m, right? So now the question say calculate. Now we're going to calculate the value for number 5a by using this equation. So that means the g is 1.5 times 4 times square root 81. So the answer is 1.5 times 4 times 9. Square root 81 is 9. So the answer is 36 times 1.5. So the answer is 54 for the g. Alright? Okay, meaning that you have to find the constant k, and after that you have to substitute the constant k into the equation, then you substitute the information into the equation and solve the g. Alright? Okay, settle. So this one you do on your own. Okay, now I'd like to discuss the question that involving table form. Okay, let's discuss one question involving table form. So for this one, you see changes of the three quantities, P varies directly as the Q and R, right? The keyword is cube of Q and R. So P varies directly as cube. Okay, cube of Q, that means Q cube. And R means multiplied by R. Got it? Okay, read the question carefully. Again, you are given the information here in three quantities. P varies, right? Directly is important. Okay, and then cube of R, okay? Cube of Q and R. Cube of Q, meaning that this one, cube of Q. The R no cube. Cube of Q and R. Okay, make sure you are writing the correct one. Then, you will make it equal first, okay? Now, how to find the K? You go to the table, you find one set of data, okay, with no unknown, with a P, with a Q, and with a R, then you substitute, right? So you got the 86.4, you go to K, 1.2 cube times 10, right? So then the K will be 86.4 divided by 1.2 cube divided by 10. Okay, or you can say divided by 1.2 cube times 10. Okay, so then you can press your calculator. 86.4 divided by 1.2 divided by 1.2 cube, right? So you can divide by 1.2 three times, or you can divide by 1.2 cube, right? And then you divide by 10 again. It's not multiply, it's divide. Alright, so you get the constant K, right? Okay, always double check. Again, we press twice. 86.4 divided by 1.2 to the power of 3. Okay, you get 50, and then you divide by 10. So make sure you get the K 5 tally twice. Alright, after you got a K, that means you're going to substitute the K into here, right? So that means the P is equal to 5, right? 5, Q, 3, and then R. Okay, so now you can solve the X and Y. So now I'm going to write my equation. 5 Q, okay, my P equal to 5 Q cube R. So now I'm going to solve this. Right, I'm going to solve this. That means the P is X, the Q is 2, 2 cube is 8, right? And the R is 0.4. So I'm going to solve my X is 5 times 8, 40. 40 times 0.4, you will get answer 16, right? Alright, so now let's set for another set of data. For this one, they want you to solve the Q, right? Okay, let's highlight like this. Focus to this one. We are still using this equation. P equal to 5 Q cube R. So P is 1.215, and then 5 Q is Y power 3, and R is 9. Okay, so we're going to solve the value of Y. So I will divide by 59 is 45 equal to Y power 3. So 1.215 divided by 45. So you will get Y cube is equal to 27 over 1000. It's actually 3 over 10 power 3. Or you can press your calculator, you will get Y equal to 0.3. Alright, so that's how you solve it. You always find the constant by using the information given. After that, you can use the equation when you solve the constant. Alright, clear? This one is quite easy. So now, let's see this one for question number 8. It's actually application, right? In hot cushion. Volume of a cone, V, alright, varies directly as height and the square of its radius. Square of the radius, a cone, so we make it a KHR square. A cone with a height of 21. So now we will write the equation first. Then we substitute height given 21, radius 6, right? 6 square, and the volume you have to find the volume given 792. Okay, now let's solve. Equal to K times, you can actually solve this one first, 36, and then bring over to be divided. That means the K is equal to 792 over 21 times 36. So let's press the calculator. 792 divided by 21 divided by 36. Okay, I'm getting 22 over 21. Right, so now we will substitute the K, which is 22 over 21, into the equation. Okay, so now I'm going to do that. So I'm using this one, so my V is 22 over 21 HR square. Okay, calculate the volume of the cone. Height is 14, so volume is equal to 22 over 21 times the 14 times the radius, which is 15, right? Let's see. Okay, let me see what is the 15, right? Okay, so write again. Okay, 15 square. This is our formula, 22 over 21 HR square. So now you press your calculator, 22 over 21 times 14 times the 15 square, right? So the answer will be 3300 cubic centimeter. Alright, this is hot question. 3300 cubic centimeter. Alright, so we have actually learned what is direct variation. We also learned what is joint variation for the direct variation. So over here, there are so many example application. So you can try on your own, and you can try how to do the hot question by using understanding of the problem. Okay, and then you have to planning. Alright, planning. After you plan, you have to implement the plan, and then you have to do checking, right? These are the four steps. UPIC, right? So you try to study the example. Okay, study the example first before you attempt all the hot question. Alright, okay, so when you free, I'm going to make another video to discuss all the hot question. So I think for today's lesson, you just do the homework for 1.1C for all the questions that I discussed. Okay, so I'm going to continue in my next video teaching for the hot question involving direct variation, and we'll actually proceed to the inverse direction. Alright, okay, so you can try first for these three before I discuss. So I think that's all for my sharing for today. Till then, I shall see you in my next video teaching. Bye bye and have a nice day.